Once upon a time, in a faraway land, a young prince lived in a shining castle. Although he had everything his heart desired, the prince was spoiled, selfish, and unkind. But then, one winter's night, an old beggar woman came to the castle and offered him a single rose in return for shelter from the cold. By her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at the gift and turned the old woman away. But she warned him not to be deceived by appearances, for beauty is found within. And when he dismissed her again, the old woman's ugliness melted away to reveal her beautiful enchantress. The prince tried to apologize, but it was too late, for she had seen that there was no love in his heart. As punishment, she transformed him into a hideous beast and placed a powerful spell on the castle and all who lived there. Ashamed of his monstrous form, the beast concealed himself inside his castle with a magic mirror as his only window to the outside world. The rose she had offered was truly an enchanted rose, which would bloom for many years. If he could learn to love another and earn their love in return by the time the last petal fell, then the spell would be broken. If not, he would be doomed to remain a beast for all time. As the years passed, he fell into despair and lost all hope. But who could ever learn to love a beast?
Sorry. the fool, and I've got my sights set on that
one.
She's the one, the lucky girl I'm going to marry.
That's me.
The most beautiful girl in town.
Oh, man.
That makes her the best. And don't I deserve the best?
Of course you
do. Right from the moment when I met her, saw her, I said she's gorgeous and I fell. Here in town there's only she, who's as beautiful as me. So I'm making plans with Mary Bell.
Have a good time in town today?
I got a new book.
Oh, you do love those books.
Well, they take me away to wonderful places, where there's adventure and mystery and romance and happy endings. Papa, if I ask you something, will you answer me honestly?
Don't I always?
Do you think I'm odd?
My daughter? Odd? Never did you get an idea like that.
Well, I don't know. It's just that, well, people talk.
Well, they talk about me, too. No, I'm not odd nor you. No family ever saner. Except one uncle who, well, maybe let that pass. In all you say or do, you couldn't make it plainer. You are your mother's daughter, therefore you are class.
So I should just accept I'm simply not like them.
They are the common herd, and you can take my word. You are unique, creme de la creme. No matter what you do, I'm on your side. And if my point of view is somewhat misty-eyed, there's nothing clearer in my life than what I wish and feel for you. And that's a lot, no matter what.
No matter what they say, you make me proud. I love the funny way you stand out from the crowd.
It's my intention, my invention shows the world out there one day just what we've got. No matter what. Now some may say your fathers just exaggerate.
That every daughter's great.
You are.
And every daughter tends to say her father's tops.
She pulls out all the stops to praise him and quite rightly. No matter what the pain, we've come this far. I pray that you remain exactly as you are. This really is a case of father knowing best. Or never strange.
Don't ever change.
You're all I've got, no matter what. Now, what do you say we give her a try?
All right.
I'm getting too old for this.
You never.
Very good, very good. All right, stand back. Here we go.
It works.
It does. It does. Yippee!
Papa, you did it. You really did it. You win first prize at the fair tomorrow. I just know it.
Who knows? Maybe I will at that.
I almost forgot. I made you this scarf for good luck.
Oh, now I know I'll win. And then we'll get out of this town and travel to all those places you've read about in your books. Well, I'm off.
Goodbye, Papa.
Bye-bye, Belle.
Be careful.
Next time.
this thing to go in reverse. First prize is nearly mine. It's quite my best invention. So simple yet complex, so massive yet so small. This triumph of design will be my old age pension. That is, providing I can find the fare at all. I must have missed a sign. I should have paid attention. Drat! That's not a nightingale.
Maybe he'll go away.
Is someone here?
Not a word, Lumiere, not one word.
I don't mean to intrude, but I've lost my way in the woods and I need a place to stay for the night.
Poor fellow. Count's well, very hard. Monsieur, you are welcome here.
I heard that. I know there's someone here and I'll thank you to step out where I can see you.
Hello.
Ah! And goodbye.
Wait. You're a clock? And you're talking?
Astonishing, isn't it? And quite inexplicable. Now, goodbye, sir.
Cotsworth! I'm surprised at you. Where are your manners?
We've got to get him out of here before the master finds out.
This is incredible. How is this accomplished?
What, really, sir? You just...
Stop that, I say.
Really, sir? You mind?
Well, I was stumped. Maybe it's some kind of newfangled scientific gadget?
Aye, sir. Not a gadget.
I do beg your pardon. I don't mean to be rude. It's just that I've never seen a talk to
achoo! Oh, bless you.
You are chilled as a bone, monsieur. Come, warm yourself by the fire.
No, I forbid it. Lumiere, the head of this household, I demand that you stop right there. Oh, in the master's chair. I'm not seeing this.
Ooh la la, what do we have here? Do my eyes deceive me, or is this a man? It's been so long since I've seen a real man. No offense, Lumiere. Hello, monsieur, mind if I sit here?
Oh, well, hello.
All right, it's gone on far enough. Finds out that we let a stranger in?
Calm yourself, Cogswell. The master will never have to know.
As I was saying, he's bound to find out sooner or later.
Should we hide, Mama?
No, no. Remain calm. There's absolutely no reason to panic.
Lumiere's right. There's absolutely no reason to panic. May I borrow this?
There's a stranger here!
Master, allow me to explain. Sir gentleman was set upon by wolves.
Who let him in?
Master, may I take this opportunity to say that I was against it from the start.
Who dared to disobey me?
Oh, dear!
You have all betrayed me! Who are you?
Maurice?
What are you doing in my castle?
I lost my way in the woods.
You are unwelcome!
Oh, I'm sorry. I'll just be on my way. Oh.
It's hideous, isn't it?
Oh, no, I wasn't.
You've come to stare at the beast, haven't you?
No, I meant no harm. I was merely looking for a place to stay.
I'll give you a place to stay!
Face to face with destiny.
yes, or is it,
oh, yes?
I just don't deserve you.
Who does?
Me!
But thanks for asking!
But I'll have Belle for my wife. Make no mistake about that.
Well, gee, if she turns him down, then maybe I can have a chance.
Oh, no,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no. Is he gone? Can you believe it? He asked me to be his wife. Me, the wife of that boorish, brainless, Madame Gaston, can't you just see it? Madame Gaston, his little wife. No, sir, not me. I guarantee it. I want much more than this provincial life. I'm much adventure in the great wide somewhere. I want it more than I can.
She always was too vain about her looks. That's exactly what she's become.
A vanity.
Little Crow, Mirrors, the works.
And poor Jean-Claude.
Who?
You remember Jean-Claude. Not too bright, dumb as...
A brick?
The whole wall.
Jean-Claude's a brick wall?
That's him in the kitchen, behind the stove. And you know Coulier, the housewife?
Oh, that mealy-mouthed little bootlicker? Oh, I've never liked him. He's always groveling at the master's feet.
He's a doormat.
Perfect.
It's happening faster with some as the others, but we are not far behind. Slowly but surely, as every day passes, we will all gradually become beings.
But why did we have to get dragged into this whole spell business? I mean, it's not like we threw that poor old beggar woman out on her ear.
No, but are we not responsible too? For helping to make ends the way he is?
Oh, I suppose so.
All I know is that I will eventually melt away into nothing. I only hope there's something left for me if the master ever breaks the spell.
Just hold on, old man. We've got to hold on.
Hello? Is anyone there? Hello?
It's a girl.
Yes, of course I can see it's a girl.
It's a girl! Mademoiselle!
No, let me do most of the talking.
Woo-hoo!
As head of the household, I should do most of the talking.
Shahi!
A word, just a word, that's all I'm asking for.
Mama, you're not going to believe what I saw. Not in a million thousand years, not in a trillion million thousand years.
Yes, Chip.
No, really. This is the greatest thing. It's the thing we've been waiting for since I don't know when.
All right, Chip. What is it?
There's a girl in the castle.
Bless my soul. Wouldn't that be lovely?
But there is. I saw her.
Now, Chip, I'll not have you making up wild stories, getting everyone's hopes up for no reason.
Did you hear? There is a girl in the castle. See, I told ya. And she's real pretty, too.
Well, I don't know about that.
She's the one. The girl we've been waiting for. She's come to break the spell.
Now, wait a minute. Let's not be hasty.
Isn't this wonderful? After all these years, oh, happy, happy day.
Oh, stop it. Stop that.
We should tell the others, no?
Yes. I mean, no. I mean, Lumiere, wait. Lumiere?
Hello? Is anyone there? Please, I'm looking for my father.
Belle? Is that you?
Papa!
How did you find me?
Your hands are like ice. We have to get you out of here.
Belle, you must leave this place.
Who's done this to you?
There's no time to explain. You must go now.
I won't leave you here. Who's there? I know someone's there. Who are you?
The master of this castle.
Then you're the one who's responsible for this. Release my father at once.
I am the master of this castle. I do not take orders from anyone. Throw her out.
What? No! No, wait, forgive me. Please. Can't you see he's not well?
He shouldn't have trespassed here.
But he's an old man. He could die.
He came into my home uninvited, and he will suffer the consequences.
Please, I'll do anything.
Belle!
There's nothing you can do.
Wait, please!
I said there's nothing you can do.
Take me instead!
No! What did you say?
Take me instead.
Belle, you don't know what you're doing. You would do that? You would take his place?
If I did, would you let him go?
Yes, but you promised to stay here forever.
No!
Forever
or he dies in the dungeon.
That's not fair. Wait. Come into the light.
Make your choice.
Belle, listen to me. I'm old. I've lived my life.
You have my word.
Done.
Papa!
Please,
no.
I'm begging you, spare my daughter.
Papa!
Take him into the crossroads!
Wait, no, not yet!
Please, let her go! Let her go!
Papa!
Master, please. Since the girl is going to be with us for quite some time, you might want to offer her a more comfortable room.
I didn't get to say goodbye.
What?
I'll never see him again. And I didn't even get to say goodbye.
I'll show you to your room.
My room?
Did you want to stay in that dungeon?
No.
Then follow me. You follow me. This is your home now. You're free to go wherever you'd like, except for the West Wing.
Why?
What? It's forbidden. You are never to set foot there. Do you understand? Do you understand?
Yes.
Thank you.
servants will attend to. And one more thing. You will join me for dinner. That is not a request.
Yes, I made the choice. For Papa, I will stay. But I don't deserve to lose my freedom in this way, you monster! If you think that what you've done is right, well then, you're a fool. Think
my drawers.
Woo!
That's very kind of you, but I'm not going to dinner.
Don't be silly, of course you are. You heard what the master said.
He may be your master, but he's not mine.
I'm sorry. This is just happening so fast.
That was a very brave thing he did, my dear.
We all think so.
I'm just going to miss my papa so much.
Cheer up, child. I know things may seem bleak right now, but you mustn't despair.
We're here to see you through.
I hope that we'll be friends, though I don't know you well. If anyone can make the most of living here, then hell, it's you.
Ah!
We're sweating, we're all.
dinner ready, Miss Potts?
Just about. I haven't the foggiest idea of what she likes to eat. So I've cooked up everything in the kitchen.
Good, good, good. Don't just stand there gaping. Get back to work.
You tell him.
I can't.
Tell me what?
Now, don't get upset. But you've got something on your back.
What on earth are you talking about?
Oh, what is that?
It appears to be a winding handle of sorts.
Well, get it off me!
It won't come off.
What do you mean it won't come off? It wasn't there last night when I went to bed. What's going on? Why is this happening to me?
It's the spell, I'm afraid.
Just try to relax.
Relax? Relax? How can I relax with this appendage on my back? Is there no dignity left for me? I mean, what's going to go next to my mind?
Calm down, Cogswell. It'll be all right.
I'm frightened, Lumiere.
I know, my friend, but you're not alone.
We're all in this together.
It's time for dinner. Where is she?
Perhaps I'll see about her. Won't be a minute.
I told her to come to dinner. What is taking her so long?
Try to be patient, sir. The girl has lost her father and her freedom all in one day.
Master, have you thought that perhaps this could be the girl who breaks the spell?
Of course I have. I'm no fool.
Good. So, you fall in love with her, she falls in love with you, and poof, the spell is broken. I'll be human again by midnight.
Lumiere, it's not that easy. These things take time.
But we don't have time. The rose has already begun to wilt.
It's no use. She's so beautiful. Well, look at me.
He has a point.
Shh! Master, you must help us see past all that.
I don't know how.
Well, you could start by trying to make yourself look more presentable. Straighten up. Try to act like a gentleman.
Impress her with your rapier wit.
But be gentle.
Shower her with compliments.
But be sincere.
And above all,
what?
You must control your temper.
Well?
What?
Where is she?
Who? Oh, yes, the girl. She's actually in the process of circumstances being what they are. She's not coming.
What did you say?
She's not coming. She's not coming.
Oh, we'll see about that.
Your Eminence, Your Lordship, Your Grace, let's not be hasty.
Everyone stay where you are. Lumiere, stand aside.
Master.
I told you to come to dinner.
I'm not hungry.
I am the master of this castle, and I am telling you to come to dinner.
And I'm telling you I'm not hungry.
You're hungry if I say you're hungry.
Don't be ridiculous. You can't just go around ordering people to be hungry.
I can.
Besides, it's rude.
Oh, rude is it? Then how about this? If you don't come down to dinner, I will drag you by the hair on top
master.
Of
your... That may not be the best way to win the girl's affection.
Please attempt to be a gentleman.
But why is she being so difficult? Why are you being so difficult?
Why are you being such a bully?
Because I want you to come to dinner.
Ah, so you admit you're being a bully.
Deep breath, Master. Deep breath.
I'll give her one last chance. Would you be so kind to join me for dinner? Please!
No, thank you.
Fine, then stop!
Master, please!
If she doesn't eat with me, then she doesn't eat at all.
What were we thinking? We will never be human again.
So it appears.
Well, what would you two have us do? Give up? I can't give up until I hear the sound of my boy's laughter as he runs through these holes again.
Quite right, Mrs. Potts. We mustn't give up while there's still a chance. Lumiere, stand watch at the door, and if there's the slightest change, inform me at once.
We won't get done.
I asked nicely, but she refuses. What? What does she want me to do? Beg? Show me the girl.
I know the master can be temperamental, but underneath all that matted fur, he's really not such a bad fellow. Why don't you give him a chance? Why should I? Did he give my father a chance? Woo!
Get a chance to know
him. I don't want to get to know him. I don't want anything to do with him.
It's no use. She'll never see me for anything other than a monster. How long must this go on? This cruel trick of fate. I simply made one careless wrong decision. And then that which was gone and left me in this state, an object of revulsion and derision, hated. Is there no one who can show me how to win the world's forgiveness? No! What did they tell me? Shower her with compliments. Impress her with your wit. Act like a gentleman. Act like a gentleman. Act like a gentleman.
Lumiere! Lumiere!
Babette! Come to me, my little flower. Help you!
It's my aunt, isn't it? Don't love me anymore. Oh, this horrible, horrible spell.
Oh, chérie. Did you really think a little thing like this would change my feelings for you? Now you really tickle my fancy.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Oh, no, no, no. I've been bounced by you before.
Actually, madame, I am a little hungry.
Woo!
And sing you an aria while we wait. That's all right. I can go myself.
What about the master? He's really not gonna like this.
I know.
Oh dear. Oh, dear.
I love this girl. I like her spunk.
Well, if you ask me, she was being rude. After all, he did say please.
I think that may be the first time I've ever heard him use that word.
I believe you're right.
You see, she's already started to have a good influence on him. Oh, there you are, dearie. Glad to see you out and about.
I'm Cogsworth, head of the household.
Cogsworth, the girl, she's gone. I swear my eyes never left so...
Oh, enchanté, mademoiselle.
And this is Lumiere. Stop it, stop that. If there's anything we can do to make your stay more comfortable, anything at all.
I am a little hungry.
Except that
Cogsworth!
Well, you heard what the master said.
Oh, pish tosh! I'm not about to let the poor child go hungry.
All right, fine, fine. Glass of water, crust of bread.
Cogsworth, I'm surprised at you. She's not the prisoner, she's our guest. We must make her feel welcome here.
All right, dinner, but keep it down. If the master finds out, it'll be our next.
Of course.
But with this dinner, with some little music.
Music?
Ma chère mademoiselle, it is with deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we invite you tonight. And now, we invite you to relax. Let us put up a chair as the dining room proudly presents. Ahem. Your dinner. Be our guest. Be our guest. Put our service to the test. Tie a napkin around your neck, sherry, and we provide the rest. Soup de jour, hot elder, why? We only live to serve. Try the gray stuff.
It's delicious.
Don't believe me, ask the dishes. They can see. After all, Miss Mrs. France, and the dinner here is never second best. Go on and hold your menu, take a glance and then you'll be our guest. Be our guest, be our guest. Be frank, be a cheesy way. I am putting on Bombay. We'll prepare and serve a clarin. Complaining while the fat whale's entertaining. I do tricks with my fellow candlesticks.
And it's all in perfect taste I can get back.
Come on and lift your glass. You want your own free pass.
Don't be our guest.
If you're stressed, it's fine dining we suggest.
Be our guest, be our guest, be our guest.
temple without a soul to wait upon. Ah, those good old days when we were useful. Suddenly those good old days are gone.
10 years we've been rusting, needing so much laws and dusting, needing exercise, a chance to use our skills.
Most days we just play around the castle.
Very fat and lazy, you walk in the whoopsie daisy. Pepe! Is that what it looks like?
Lumiere, look what you said to me last time.
You know you're still gonna come in. You really like my fire.
Come to me, my little spark.
That's true!
Lumiere, this time you've gone too far. It's shameless! Shameless!
Oh, Belle? Belle?
Now, if you will note the unusual inverted archways, you will see that this is yet another example of the late neoclassic Baroque period. And as I always say, if it's not Baroque, don't fix it. May I draw your attention to our flying buttresses above the aviary?
It's all so beautiful. I had no idea. If only he weren't here.
Act like a gentleman? I am nothing but a fool.
And thanks to some quick thinking on my part, the disaster was averted. And that was the last time a stone of that weight was quarried in this area.
What's up there?
Nothing!
Nothing of all of the interest in the West Wing.
Ah, so that's the West Wing.
Nice going.
I wonder what he's hiding.
Hiding, she says. What an idea, hiding.
Then it wouldn't be forbidden, would it?
Perhaps Mademoiselle would like to see something else. We have exquisite tapestries dating all the way back to the Aloysius the Pretentious.
Maybe later.
Perhaps you'd like to see the gardens? Or the library?
You have a library?
With books!
Oh yes, forested books, mountains of bursts, cloud bursts, swamps of books.
Books with pictures, book with words.
More words than you can ever read in a lifetime.
Books by every subject, by every author, whoever set pen to papier.
Careless and
Thank you.
hadn't run away, this wouldn't have happened.
Well, if you hadn't frightened me, then I wouldn't have run away.
Well, you shouldn't have been in the West Wing.
And you should learn to control your temper. Just hold still. This may sting a little. By the way, thank you for saving my life.
You're welcome.
You see? That's more like it. I knew they'd get away if they tried.
So, the ice is broken at last.
And not a moment too soon either. I'm taking a good look at the rose lady. It's losing petals at an alarming rate.
Not to mention the fact that I can hardly bend over at all anymore.
Clearly, it's time for us to give him a little push. We must find a nice, romantic way to bring them closer together.
I have just the thing. How about we warm you two up with a nice bowl of soup?
Soup?
Trust me.
There's something sweet and almost kind, but he was mean and he was coarse and unrefined. And now he's dear and so unsure. I wonder why I didn't see it there before. What a gentleman. I fell, I took.
I thought I saw, and when we touched, she didn't shudder at my palm. No, it can't be, I'll just ignore. But then she's never looked at me a way before. When she looks at me, I get all choked up, my heart starts pounding, and I can't breathe.
Good.
That's good?
Excellent.
I've never felt this way about anyone. I want to give her something, but what?
Well, there's the usual things. Flowers, chocolates, promises you don't intend to keep.
What? No! This is no ordinary girl. You must give us something special. Something that sparks her interest. Something... Ah!
What? Are you sure? Well...
Say something about the dress.
It's pink!
A compliment!
What a nice dress.
Thank you.
Well, I want to show you something. Before I do it, you have to close your eyes. It's a surprise.
Get the girl!
Can I open them?
Yes. Okay, now!
I can't believe it! I've never seen so many books in my whole life!
You like it?
It's wonderful!
Then it's yours!
Even look at the book in, I don't even know how long.
Was it you who taught him how to read?
It wasn't me, but I don't think that really matters. Thanks, Mama. Well, who would have thought?
Oh, bless my soul!
Who would have
never?
Well, who indeed?
And who would have guessed they'd come together on their own?
So peculiar, wait and see. A few days more, and maybe something there that wasn't there before.
There may be something there that wasn't there before.
What? There may be something
there that wasn't there before.
What's there, Mama?
Shh. I'll tell you in ropes. Come along. Let's give them some privacy.
Mama?
Yes, Chip?
Will I ever get to be a boy again?
I hope so.
When will I know?
Soon. If it's to be, it'll be very soon.
Knowing not that this was indeed the legendary sword called Excalibur, Arthur tried to pull it from the stone. He tried once, to no avail. He tried a second time, but still could not pull it out. Then, for the third time, Arthur drew forth the sword.
So that must mean he's king.
Wait and see.
I had forgotten what could do that.
Do what?
Take me away from it. Make me forget, for a little while.
Forget?
Who I... what I am.
We have something in common, you know.
What's that?
In the town where I come from, the people think I'm odd.
You?
So I know how it feels to be different. And I know how lonely that can be. Then, for the third time, Arthur drew forth the sword, and there arose from the crowd a great shout. Arthur is king!
Told you so.
Are they still in there?
Yes, and so far, he has been a perfect gentleman.
You know what, Mama? I have a funny feeling inside. I'm not sure what it is, but it makes me kind of bubbly.
It's hope, son. I've been feeling it too.
Ah, oui, my little friend. Today we've waited for maybe a hand.
If only that were true,
yeah?
Human again.
Human again.
Yes, think what that means. I'll be cooking again, be good cooking again, with a mademoiselle on each arm. When I'm human again, only human again, poised and polished and gleaming with charm. I'll be quilting again, she can spelting again,
which of course several husbands are love.
I'll come down off the shelf
and to sweet be myself.
I can't wait to be human again.
When we're human again, only human again, when we're nip-knacks and whatnots no more,
we can push little shells, they can wash my mouth.
Ah, Chefy, we'll fool, we talk cruel. I'll bend it to get bruised, and I will be subdued by easily fit through the door. I'll include some of her, I'll wear gowns on her heads, my prayer to be human again.
When I'm human again, only human again, when the world once more starts making sense, I'll unwind for a change.
Really, that would be strange.
Can I help it if I'm tense? In a shack by the sea, I'll sit back sipping tea, lest my early retirement commence. Far from fools made of wax, I'll get down to brass tacks and relax.
I'm human again. Sweep the dust from the floor. Let's let it still light in the room. I can feel, I can tell, someone might break the spell any day now.
Shine up the brass on the door.
Out the dust fell and bloom.
If it all goes as planned, our time may be at hand any day now. Open the shutters and let in some air.
When Guinevere heard that Arthur was slain, she stole away to a convent, and no one could ever make her smile again. That's the end.
What a beautiful story.
I knew you'd like it. I'd like to ask you for something.
What's that?
A second chance. Would you have dinner with me tonight?
Dinner? Me with you? That'd be... I mean... Oh, yes!
When we're human again, only human again, when
don't usually leave the asylum in the middle of the night. This fellow here said you'd make it worth my while.
Look, I've got my heart set on marrying Belle. She needs a little persuasion.
Turn them down flat!
It's like this, see? There's a danger, I'll be thwarted and denied my honeymoon. For the pretty thing I courted refuses to swoon. So the time has come for a murky plan, for which I turn to a murky man.
I had been
where better than the Maison de Lune. I don't take this girl for granted. There's no path I haven't moved. To her heart no seed I'm planted, no flowers I'm strewn. But quite amazing to her late, she doesn't want me for her mate.
I don't wish to seem a tad obtuse, but I don't see how I can be a fool. See, I got people up, I'm not a lonely heart's club. I'm a good-held fish, I'm a nasty, vicious snake.
Please speak!
It's Belle's father who's your client. She adores the old buffoon. She'll be forced to be compliant.
She'll dance to your tune.
Hey! We get the daughter through her dad. You just pronounce the old boy mad.
And won't she slam up in your head?
Do I make myself entirely clear?
It's the simplest deal of my whole foul career.
Put Maurice away and she'll be here in moments. In a dreadful state, the capitulate on me.
Oh, I'll be striking a big deep very kindly, very soon. But please don't bring her in late. I'm checking times noon.
Hey!
So wait, my bachelor tonight.
She'll be my bride at their door.
Then see her daddy.
Also fine.
In my sordid salon.
So put the church raised glasses high to the Maison de Lune.
Tonight is the night. The night you confess your love.
I'm really not sure I can do that.
You must.
You care for the girl, don't you?
More than anything.
Then why not tell her?
I can't.
You must.
There will be beautiful music, romantic candlelight, provided by myself. And then, when the moment is right...
Oh, will I know when the moment is right?
You'll feel slightly nauseous.
No.
No!
You will know because you will feel it here. You must speak from the heart.
I must speak from... I can't.
You must.
What are you afraid of?
Nothing.
Master.
I'm afraid she might...
She might what?
Laugh.
Somehow, my prince, you must find the courage to take the chance.
Master, look at the rose. There's so little time left.
I'm really not sure I can do this.
Here. This might help bolster your courage.
Ah!
You can do it, Master. I know you can.
Thank you.
as old as time. True as it can be, barely even friends, then somebody bends unexpectedly. Just a little change, small to say the least, but a little scared, neither one prepared.
Oh, no, I
can't swim her!
Ever just the same, ever a surprise, ever as before, ever just as sure as the sun will rise. Tale as old as time, as old as songs, bitter, sweet and strange, finding you can change, learning you are wrong. Certain as the sun rising in the east, tale as old as time, song as old as rhyme, beauty as the
dinner bell.
Dinner was wonderful.
Bell, are you happy here?
Oh yes, everyone's so kind. Mrs. Potts, Lumiere.
With me?
Yes.
I must speak from... Is something wrong?
Oh, I was just thinking about my father. I miss him so much. I wish there were some way I could see him again.
There is a way. This mirror will show you anything you wish to see.
I'd like to see my father, please. Papa? Oh no, Papa! Something's wrong. I think he's lost. He's in the woods. I should...
Go to him.
What?
You should go to him.
What about
you're not my prisoner anymore. You haven't been for a very long time. Keep it. It'll give you a way to look back. Something to remember me by.
I could never forget you.
Belle?
Yes?
Go. Go, go. I will never see her again.
Well, Master, I must say, everything is going just swimmingly. I knew you had it in you.
I let her go.
You what?
How could you do that?
I had to.
But why?
After all this time, he's finally learned to love.
That's it then. That should break the spell.
It's not enough. She has to love him in return.
And now it's too late.
I'm sorry.
No spell has been broken, no words have been spoken, no point anymore if she can't love me. No hope she would do so, no dreams to pursue. So I finally know that I will always
Emily home. Rest here.
I don't know what happened. The last thing I remember, I was falling.
You were in the woods, Papa. I thought I'd never find you.
But how did you escape?
I didn't escape. He let me go.
That terrible beast? He let you go?
He's not so terrible. At first, I thought it was the end of everything, but somehow, things changed.
How?
I'm not sure, but when I look at him, I seem different. It's funny. I look around, and I see the whole world different. There's been a change in me, a kind of moving on.
Show me the had feelings for this monster.
He's not the monster, Gaston. You are.
She's as crazy as the old man. She says this creature is her friend. Well, I've hunted wild beasts and I've seen what they can do. The beasts will make off with their children. We'll come after them at night.
He will never do that.
Forget the old man. I say we kill the beast.
Yeah! Oh, we're not safe until he's dead. He'll come stalking us at night.
Let's sacrifice our children to his monster's appetite.
They're becoming garbage if we let him wander free.
So it's time to take some action, boys.
Darkness and the shadows is a nightmare, but one exciting ride. Say a prayer that we're there at the drawbridge of a castle, into something truly terrible inside. It's a big bang, creatures, sharp ones, massive paws, killer claws for the beast. Hear him roar, see him boom, but we're not going home till he's dead. Go ahead, die, kill the beast.
Yeah! I won't let you do this.
Try and stop us.
Papa, this is all my fault. I have to go back and warn him.
I'm coming with you.
No.
I lost you once. I'm not going to lose you again.
Then we better hurry.
We'll rid the village of this beast. Who's with me?
Thunder horse.
Your carpet said this digging place.
There's something on this hole to lead the way.
Thank you.
A girl like that? No! A creature like you! She despises her beast, and she sent me here to destroy you!
No!
It's over, beast! Belle is mine!
No!
Let me down! Let me down, please! I beg you!
No! No!
I'm sorry! Take my hand!
You came back.
Of course I came back. I couldn't let them. If only I'd come sooner.
Maybe it's better this way.
Don't talk like that. Everything will be fine.
At least I got to see you one last time.
We're together now. You'll see.
Are you human again?
find your father. Who was that young man?
It was the prince.
No, it wasn't.
Yes, it was.
No, it wasn't.
It most certainly was. Babette, you're so much better.
What do you mean? I thought you'd like to wear uniform.
I did. It's just I like you better this way.
Then you were lying to me.
No, I wasn't.
Yes, you were.
No, I wasn't.
Yes, you were.
No. Well, maybe a little.
Yeah. I like you better this way, too.
Magnificence and Excelsius.
Oh, Carter, remember I wore this night I performed at the Prince
of I know, my darling, you were wonderful.
Carter. Chip? Chip? Have you seen my boy? Of course, my dear, of course. Do I